Story 1. On the road. It's happened 3 times now, driving down that road. It all started because my friend and I were on our way back from her boyfriend's house to her mom's house. It's a few towns away. I was heading north. She told me to keep going straight because it seemed easier than zigzagging to her mom's house and having to go through other towns. So we took that road, and both of us realized we'd never been down that road before. We ended up sort of getting lost because of the curves in the road. As we took this one curve, we both noticed something to the right side of the road. It took the form of a man, about 6 or 7 feet tall, on the side of the road. And as we drew closer, we could see what was the outline of what we assumed was a man. It looked like he had a long coat and a top hat. Aside from that, we couldn't see any other details. As we drew up alongside this figure, he started to run towards the woods, and we slowed down to watch. Why was he doing it? He jumped onto a tree and started to climb it. I don't know how he could jump 15 feet onto a tree like that. We were both so unnerved by this and overcome with the feeling of panic that we began to cry. It was all I could do to get us out of there. I wish it was the last time I saw it, but we had to take that road again. One night to drop my other friend off at her grandmother's house. It was me, the same girl as the first time, and this other girl, Mary. We came around that same curve, and to what we thought was our luck, we didn't see the figure again. As we rounded the next curve, not far from where we saw it the first time, we slowed down because of a stop sign, and we were getting ready to turn onto Mary's grandmother's road. I heard Mary in the back seat scream. I turned around to see what was wrong, and the figure was behind my car. This time, I could see more of his features. He was definitely male-looking, with the most evil grin I've ever seen. His eyes were dark and pierced, and they stared right at us, laughing at us. I tried to drive. I tried to get away. I pushed my accelerator to the floor, but the car wouldn't move. I could hear my front tires squealing. I could see the figure in the rearview mirror. It had grabbed the car, and for some reason, it was strong enough to hold the car, even though I had the gas pedal to the floor. After 5 of the longest minutes of my life, the car sprung forward, and we took off. I could still see it behind us at the stop sign. It looked like it was laughing at us. Then came the last time I was forced to go down that road. My friend Travis, I thought I was crazy when I told him about the first 2 encounters. So he told me that he would take me down that road to prove that I was only making things up. I didn't want to go. We decided to take his sister Alice with us so we could have another girl with me. As we came up to that section of the road, we went around the curve. Between the curve we first encountered it and the last curve of the road, in the field, we saw a flashing light. I looked behind us, and sure enough, it was running behind the car. We sped up to about 70 miles per hour, and it was still right behind us. No human can run that fast, can they? Travis knew then that I wasn't lying. After talking to another friend of mine, he said that he too has encountered that while driving down the road. What or who is that thing? I know one thing is certain. I don't drive down that road anymore. Story 2. The Haunted Psychiatric Ward. Several years ago, I worked at a psychiatric hospital. Almost from the day I started, my coworkers would jokingly tell me that the place was haunted. I wouldn't at the time call myself a skeptic, but I felt that I would really have to see something significant before I'd call any place haunted. Throughout the first year and a half working there, I saw and heard many odd things. Doors slamming closed, faint voices, shadows out of the corner of my eye. You know, the typical haunted stuff. However, there was always a way to tell myself that it was nothing but my imagination. It was the wind, air conditioning, patients talking, etc., etc. I finally saw something I absolutely could not rationalize. I was sick that night, and there was no one to cover my shift, so I just worked through it. I cannot recall anything supernatural happening until around 5:30 a.m. We were getting ready for shift change. The bathroom employees use is separate from the ones the patients use. Our bathroom was in a seldom used room adjacent to the nurse's station. Out of every place in this hospital ward, that room and bathroom always gave me the creeps. We had some nurses and psych techs that were actually too afraid to use it and would prefer to use the patient bathroom instead. I was sick, and I was beginning to run a fairly nasty fever just before the oncoming employees began to arrive. I went and used that bathroom. I walked out of the bathroom and froze in my tracks. Standing to my left was a man, approximately as tall as myself, 6'3". He was wearing a medium brown colored pantsuit, an older style hat held in his hand. The suit was like something you'd see in the late 40s. His hair was thick and slicked back like a man from that era would wear. I saw this all as clear as day, and yet, just for a split second, because when I turned to look towards him, no one was there. I remember that. I really didn't think much of it at the time. I was sick, and I was tired. Everyone from time to time will see goofy things when they're running a fever and overly tired. I took the following day off work and came back the next night. Me and one of the other nurses would often joke about the spooks and haunts of the ward. Later, after the patients were asleep, we had begun to do our paperwork. She jokingly said to me, "Hey, you remember the other night when you were sick? I saw the ghost." And I said, "Oh yeah, where'd you see?" "Oh, it was about 5:45, just before shift change. I was coming out of the bathroom and I saw..." And I stopped her. "Wait a second. Did he look like..." And I described to her the man that I'd seen. She and everyone around us looked pale and shocked. You have to remember that these people had worked the previous night without me, because I took the night off sick. She told them all what she had seen the night before. And here we were, all sitting around tables in the middle of a dead quiet psych ward. I then described to them exactly, word for word, what I'd experienced. We had had the same exact experience, down to the T, the same man. Some people actually thought we was playing a joke on them, and it was all we could do to assure them that we were being sincere. While I worked there, a new hospital was being built, and the old building was turned into doctor's offices for outpatient clinics. I have no doubt that these doctors are experiencing some of the same things to this day that we experienced on our ward. What about the patients? I can remember on more than one occasion, in the middle of the night, a patient stepping out of a room and saying, "There's someone in my room," or "I'm hearing voices." What do you tell someone who has been diagnosed with paranoid schizophrenia? "I just saw a ghost?" "Yeah, right. There's no way I can convince myself that what I saw was just my imagination." Story 3. My haunted house. With a gravel driveway, the house was painted yellow, and I lived there in 1982. At the time, I was a sophomore in high school. I was a normal 15-year-old kid. The first night my family lived there, all the lights in the house went out, except for the garage below the small attic and the attic. The door to the small attic would slowly open with a creak and then slam shut. Often, when in the house, I'd get the feeling that someone cold, very cold, was walking up behind me and putting their right hand on my shoulder. I'd quickly turn around and the feeling would go away. When eating dinner, the sound of someone bouncing a ball could be heard over our heads. You know, like when you drop a ping pong ball and it quickly speeds up its bouncing and can go on for several minutes. Twice, while entering the garage, a large, rusty, 3-inch nail fell out of a nailless stucco ceiling, hit the floor with a ping, and then disappeared. This happened to me twice, and my father once, but he was able to pick up the nail before it disappeared. Twice, things happened while I was sleeping. Odd things. The first was reminiscent of those old Pepto-Bismol commercials, where the man is bulged out and wobbling due to his discomfort. Only, it was my closet doors bulging out and wobbling. I realized quickly that there was nothing I could do about this, so I closed my eyes and went right back to sleep. Looking back now, that's a very strange reaction. The second incident happened. It was rather simple. Someone was walking in my room. I could hear the footsteps and the boards creaking as if someone had entered my room and was walking across the floor. There was no depressions in the carpet, and I only heard 3 audible steps. Again, I just went right back to sleep. One day, while playing on the lake ice with my friend and his dog, we decided to come back and play at my house. I warned him that the house was haunted, but we'd make the best of it. When we approached the house, it took some effort to get the dog even in the front yard, but a taunting tennis ball eventually got the critter into our yard. And when we got him in the yard, we picked him up and brought him onto the porch. He fought against us strongly. From there, we took the dog by the collar and led him into the house. He froze. Instantly froze. He looked up the staircase. He whimpered. He backed up. And he ran out of the house, nearly taking us with him. We couldn't hold on to the collar, and the dog just stayed in the street, never coming close to the house or the lawn. Baffled, and not seeing any specters for ourselves, my friend and I entered the house, got cookies. After a cookie break, we went upstairs. When we moved to the house, we had a cat. The cat would normally be a house cat and stay around the house with very few late night jaunts. But when we moved in, the cat's behavior changed. It rarely spent time around the house. And finally, it just left for good. I don't know why, but animals did not seem to like this house. Like my friend's dog. Late one night, I laid down to sleep. I laid down for maybe 10 seconds. And then suddenly opened my eyes. What I saw could not exist in this world. In a period of less than 2 seconds, a gray object entered my room, flew up into the ceiling. I actually get chills just recounting this story. The object seemed to be a gray blob with enough TV screen fuzz so that it blended into the background, but it was still visible. When it entered my room, it came in 4 to 6 feet and then went straight up into the ceiling. I told my parents about this, but we really have no rationalization for this. The final incident was a real killer. I'd left a friend's house across town. I'd stayed with them while my parents were on vacation. At the time I left, the weather was lovely and sunny. But in driving 5 minutes to our house, the weather turned sour. When we got to our house, large 40-foot trees were moving like they were being whipped around. The sky was gray and angry. And it didn't make sense that the weather could change so much in just 5 miles. I've never seen anything like it before or since. Expecting to meet my parents, I was disappointed to see that they were running late. I was to face that house alone with a big storm brewing. I walked up the gravel driveway to the back of the house. I had to get inside, past the door to the basement, and then I'd be okay in the kitchen or the dining room. Once inside, and to my horror, I found the same situation that had happened to me my very first night was happening now. The lights were out in the majority of the house. It was dark. I figured that the lights in the kitchen would work, since it was directly below the small attic. I tried the lights. No dice. After 45 minutes, I started to panic. I started to feel that cold presence come up behind me. I was moving around the kitchen to try to get away from it. I didn't want to go upstairs. I was terrified that there was something up there waiting for me. If I looked at it, game over. My mind was racing. I waited huddled in the kitchen for 2 hours before my parents' car finally pulled up in the driveway. The next day, they had an electrician come out and check the wires. He said that we had partial voltage coming into the house. In any case, we moved soon after. We've had no bizarre occurrences in the house since then. We realize now how foolish it was to stay in that haunted house for as long as we did. It felt like as soon as we left, a weight was lifted off of us. We just wondered why we stayed. Years later, I went back to that neighborhood, and I asked some of the neighbors what they knew about the house and the people who owned it before. It turns out that previous owners had a very violent relationship and that someone may have been murdered in the house. One of them is buried on the property. Maybe it's their spirit that's trapped in that house and is influencing the people who live there and haunting them. Thanks for listening. I hope you enjoyed the stories. If you did, give me a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button. I really do appreciate it. Thanks for listening. Bye.